Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Mike Papantonio. The list of crimes being committed by America's biggest banks is almost endless, but the Supreme Court has made it harder and harder for consumers to take these criminals to court. Joining me now to tell us about this is attorney Peter Mougey. Peter, America's legal system, again, protecting Wall Street to the detriment of Main Street. Consumers don't have a chance anymore. This last case that came out where you had class actions, that was the only way for consumers to proceed against Bank of America. The court takes that right away at lower court and at the Supreme Court. Talk about how bad this is for consumers.
It's gotten ridiculous. I mean, if you are a consumer, Main Street consumer, and you have a smaller claim, and I say smaller, I mean, it could be six figures, low six figures. What the courts have effectively done, what Congress has done through legislation, especially on the securities front, is narrow down to where the Main Street does not have redress for a smaller claim. And you've seen
In this case, Bank of America, we knew that they were falsifying documents. They were lying to homeowners about the foreclosure process. They were actually forging signatures dealing with the foreclosure process. They were creating documents that were just, that they simply created out of thin air. We knew they were breaking the law, so people brought a lawsuit against them, and they made it into a class action, and the judge says, no, you can't go forward with a class action. So what does that do to a consumer if the consumer has to handle these one at a time?
If they break out these cases and they force them to bring it one at a time, which is what happened in Bank of America, no matter if they lied, they cheated, they stole, you have evidence of the same, it makes them bring an individual case. And as Pap, as you know, that bringing an individual case over $15, $20, $25, $100,000 against one of these behemoth international companies like Bank of America is almost impossible. The people can't afford it. So essentially what they've done is the door shut on seeking redress for this fraud, because the folks can't afford to bring these size claims against these huge companies like Bank of America.
And what the court is saying, no, every one of the individuals have to bring their own claim. Each claim may cost, if you're going foot to foot against Bank of America, just to get to court could be anywhere around $100,000 per claim just to get to court. And the average claimant with the Bank of America case, they were people who were foreclosed on because they couldn't even pay for their house. How are they going to pay for legal representation in a setting like that? It makes it impossible, doesn't it?
Think about it this way. Let's say there's an expert that you need to prove your case. And in a class case, which just simply means you can bundle all these cases together, you can bring the expert in one time, review the documents, and give the testimony one time. If you have each individual case, mom and pop type homeowner, have to hire that expert in every single case. And it's typically not uncommon for us to spend well into the six figures just on an expert. If you make mom and pop hire that expert in every single case one at a time, you can't get any of the efficiencies, any of the economies, and it effectively bars the Main Street from bringing a case because they can't afford to bring those kind of experts in, that type of firepower that you need to bring a case against Wall Street or against big corporations, because you just can't afford it.
At the Supreme Court level, the conservative thugs, they're really not even judges. They're simply an extension of corporate America. If you look at Roberts, Alito, Thomas, Scalia, they all come from corporate America. That's where they made all of their money. So now, when they made decisions on, for example, the AT&T case, where you basically left everybody to meaningless arbitration, or the Walmart case, where they said women may not bring cases in discrimination cases because there's simply too many. That was actually the reasoning. When they made decisions like that, they knew that their marching orders, when they sat on the Supreme Court, when they got that appointment, they knew their marching orders from corporate America was to make it difficult for consumers to ever sue big corporations like Bank of America. This is an example right here of exactly how it works, isn't it?
Well, take the AT&T case you mentioned. Essentially what that AT&T versus Concepcion case said is you're forced to arbitration. If there's a bar in the agreement barring class actions, you can't bring one. So now the Supreme Court said if there's a bar in the arbitration agreement saying you can't bring a class, you can enforce that. So that essentially says as long as fraud is small, it's cheap. Because the victims don't have a remedy. They don't have nowhere to go because they can't bring a class. And big Wall Street, big business knows that they can't afford to bring these smaller claims.
So you get to steal from consumers at $10,000 or $20,000 per person, and you can steal as much as you want because you know is even if you steal it, A, the government's not going to throw you in jail because the U.S. Justice Department doesn't have any guts. And exactly. Second of all, you don't have to worry about going to court because in the end, there's not going to be a class action. Individual lawyers are never going to be able to handle individual cases for thousands of people where you have to pay experts $50,000, $60,000, $70,000 a piece simply to come to court. Peter, this is just a continuation of Wall Street dominating both politics and in the civil justice process in America. And frankly, I'd love to say that I see a possibility of things getting better, but I really don't. Peter Mougey, thank you for joining me, okay?